Good morning, students. I am Purnima, and once again I welcome you all to my English class. Today we are going to revise the poem "The Snake Drawing," written by W.W.E. Ross. So, who is the poet student of this poem? It is W.W.E. Ross. Now, before explaining the poem, I would like to tell something about the poet W.W.E. Ross. So, William Warrington Estes Ross. Okay, he was born on June 14, 1894, and he died in August 26, 1966. He was a Canadian geophysicist and poet. So he was a Canadian geophysicist and poet. He was the first published. He was the first published poet in Canada to write imagist poetry, and later the first to write surrealistic works, both of which have led some to call him the first modern Canadian poet. So because of these two reasons, he became the first Canadian poet. Anglo-American poetry that favored precision of imagery and clear, sharp language, surrealism is a 20th century movement in art and literature which sought to release the creative potential of the unconscious mind or the irrational expressions of images. So children, this is all about the poet. Now, though not very famous, though not very celebrity, but then he came in the category of a good poet. Well, I would like to discuss you about the theme of this poem. So most of us think that snakes are fearsome symbols of death. Now children, as you can see, the title is "The Snake Drawing." Many people think that snakes are the those reptiles which are, and they are the fearful symbol of death. But the snake in this poem is itself a victim. Okay, but here it is vice versa. The snake here, which is described here, is itself a victim. The poet is telling us that we need to pause and act with a rational mind instead of being hysterical and irresponsible. So what the poet is telling, that we need to pause and act with a rational mind instead of being hysterical and irresponsible when we interact with the often harmless reptile. Pain and anxiety of the snake and the ruthlessness of pain has been depicted in the poem. So children, when snake is there, it is not a harmless snake. In this poem we will know a snake is there and it is not a harmless snake. It never bites anybody, it never harms anybody, and here children, people run to kill him unnecessarily, though he has not done any harm to anybody. But then also children, he is being followed, he is being, somebody is following him with a stick in his hand to kill him. So the snake here is full of pain and anxiety. Okay, pain and anxiety of the snake and the ruthlessness of man has been depicted in this poem. Now the snake is running, and the poet is telling that the snake is running to save his life, and one of the people who is also running after him with a stick in his hand to kill him. So here children, it is told that we are all born here, we are all the creature of God. It is God who created us, so we don't have any right to kill some animals. We don't have any right to kill any of the animals. So this is the theme of the poet, that we should not only the snake. People think it is very dangerous, If it will bite anybody, he or she will die. But that snake was not even dangerous at all. It causes no harm to anyone. It was a small snake simply lying, and children, people are running after him to kill him. So the poet is telling that whoever is responsible, we should not be doing all such type of thing. We are all the animals we are all created by God, and we should not kill anybody like this unnecessary and to the innocent animals. So here children, snake is being described as innocent. His intention is not to bite anyone. His intention is not to harm anyone. And he was lying on the sand. Suddenly he felt a stick in the hands of a bosun, and who is after his life. To save his life, the snake crawled into the pond where reeds are there. Okay, and he hides in that reed. What is a reed? It's a green color plant in the water. And finally, anyhow, he was saved. So children, the pathetic condition of the snake is being described here. Though he is not that type of snake which causes harm, he is not a poisonous snake, he never bites to anybody, but also then the people are after his life. So he is telling, we human beings are not doing any justice. We should not kill innocent animals like this snake. And this snake, children, he is not a dangerous animal, he is not a venomous snake. Is simply a green color snake which proved that he lives in water or in plants. And we all know that water and green color, the snake which is of green color which lives in plants, they never bite to anyone. So children, this is all, and now I'm going to read the summary of the poem, or just going to tell you about the important background of the poetry. Snakes are one of the many beautiful creations of nature. The poet has written about how a snake is trying to escape the onslaught of a pursuing stick. It tries to slip off and looks so beautiful while giving a curvaceous shape to its slender and thin body. Now children, poet is in a favor that many people, they doesn't like snake, but he likes the cylindrical body of the snake which is lying in a curved manner. Okay, he loves the cylindrical body of the snake which is lying in the curved manner. So he is telling, it tries to slip off and look so beautiful while giving a curvaceous shape to its slender and thin body. The snake tries to glide through the water to get away. Now children, snake is thinking to glide away from the water to escape from death, or to escape from that person who is after his life with a stick. The poet has written about how a snake is trying to escape the onslaught of a pursuing stick. It tries to slip off and looks so beautiful while giving a curvaceous shape and to a slender and thin body. The snake tries to glide through the poem, glides through the water to get away. The poet hopes that it is able to make a safe escape. He pleads through the poem to let the snake free, because it is timid green water snake that is absolutely harmless. So the poem also proves in one of the paragraph that it is a green color snake which is a total, that snake is total harmless. It will never create any harm to anyone. It will not bite. So that snake is there with them. Okay, that snake was there. And it knows even harm little children. That snake even doesn't harm the small children. He was noticed while lounging on the sand, and how it escaped to the green reed that would act as a disguise and save it. And how he dodged other and he went inside the green leaves, the reeds of the water plant, where he was not able to be seen by anybody else. So children, this is the situation of the snake. Now, children, I have told you about the theme of the poem. I have told you about the, we have discussed about the author. I have also told you about the summary. And let me tell you, give you some tip, that we are the creator of God. We don't have right to kill anybody. Like in this snake, the snake did not have, the boy did not have right to kill snake. Because even he is the creator of God, and even snake is the creator of God. So writer is telling, it doesn't look nice that we should kill anybody. Okay, so now the poem. I will be talking about the poem, and first I will read the poem, and then children, I will tell you the meaning of these words. So let's read the poem. The snake trying to escape the pursuing stick, with sudden curving of thin, long body, how beautiful and graceful are his shapes. He glides through the water away from the stroke. Oh, let him go over the water into the reeds to hide. Without hurt, small and green, he is harmless even to children. After along the sand, he lay until observed and chased away. And now he vanished in the ripples among the green slim reeds. So this is the poem which I have read for you. And in this poem you can see, children, now how nicely this poem has been written. Okay. So first I will be telling you about the, I will be doing the explanation part of the poem. Okay. The snake trying to escape the pursuing stick. Pursuing is followed or chase. Pursuing means follow or chase. So children, here the snake is going and it is being followed by the pursuing stick. The snake is followed by the pursuing stick. Well, pursuing means follow or chase. To escape the pursuing stick. To escape the pursuing stick. Okay, that means follow or chase. Okay, pursuing is follow or chase. Carving means having the shape of a curve. The snake trying to escape the pursuing stick with sudden carving of thin, long body. How beautiful and graceful are his shapes. Naturally, he had carved his body because he wanted to save himself from the pursuing stick. The body was carved. Okay, suppose if this is the snake, and if somebody is touching him here with a stick, so the snake body will be, it will become more curved. Okay, this is the stick. Okay, this is the snake body. So it will become, okay, more curved. Now, so the poet, to escape the pursuing stick with sudden curving of thin long body, how beautiful and graceful are his shape. Now children, he is telling about the shape. He is telling about the poet is telling about its shape, that how beautiful the shape has, the how beautiful is the shape of the snake. How beautiful and grace are his shape. So the poet, it tells us about a water snake that is being disturbed by a human being. who is persuading a ape with a stick. It is carving its long body into graceful and beautiful shape, even at a time when it is trying to escape. So his whole cylindrical body, it is taking a shape, it is curving, and it is looking more beautiful, even if it is pursuing, somebody is chasing him with a stick. Now, paragraph 2. He glides through the water away from the stroke. Oh, let him go. Over the water, into the reeds to hide. Without hurt, small and green is a harmless even to children. So here it is telling that the snake, he glides means move along smoothly and easily. So children, what snake is doing? It is gliding, it is smoothly. What is the meaning of glide? It is moving in a very, it is moving along smoothly and easily. From the stroke, stroke is an act of hitting or striking someone or something. An act of hitting or striking someone or something. A blow. Reeds. Tall, slender leaved plant of the grass family in the water. So what is a reed? It is a tall, slender, it's just like a big grass in the water. So he glides through the water away. Now what the snake is doing? He is smoothly and easily moving through the water from the stroke. From the stroke is an act of hitting or striking somebody or something, a blow. Now children, he is striked, he has been given a blow, and children, he is moving, he is gliding just to save himself. Okay, he already got a blow from the stick. Oh, let him go over the water. Now children, the rider is telling, oh, he is running to save himself. Let him go towards the water, towards the pond. There he can save himself. Because why? Into the reeds he had to hide. Because there are reeds. What is reed? It's a tall, slender leaved plant of the grass family, which grow in water or in marshy ground. That is a tall grass from the reed family. It grow in a marshy ground. Into the reeds to hide. So snake is moving towards the reed to hide. Without hurt, small and green, he is harmless even to children. Now the rat is telling that snake, it's very innocent, he is not biting anyone, even he is safe to the children, he never bites. Without, even he is being hit by the stick, then also he is not biting anyone. So the snake slips through the water smoothly and easily to escape from being bit by a stick. The poet is hoping that the snake is able to escape into the reeds and hide there without being hurt. He adds that the poor snake is small and green and does not harm even little children. Along the sand he lay until I observed and chased away, and now he vanishes in the ripples among the green slim reed. Now observed is seen or spotted. What is the meaning of observe? Observe means seen or spotted. Okay, to find out. See, then vanishes is disappear suddenly. Vanishes means vanishes here means disappear, and he disappears suddenly and completely. Ripples move in a way resembling small waves. Ripples move in a way in a way resembling small waves. Okay, so you can see, children, along the sand he lay until observed. Now, children, the snake, he was lying in the snake, stretched himself, okay, when he was observed and chased away, and now he vanishes in the ripple. And he was being chased away with a stick, and he hit in the vanishes in the ripple among the green slim reeds. So, children, you can see here the poet is describing that it is a time he was observed. He was simply lying on the sand. The little snake stretched itself along the sand. As soon as he was disturbed and chased by the pursuing stick, he vanished into the water and hid among the slim green leaves of the water reeds. So just he saved himself, he hid somewhere in the water reeds, he disappeared through the ripples of the water, and finally nobody was able to search him, and in this way he was saved. So children, with this I end the poem here. Now we are having some poetic devices also, like imagery in stanza 1, to escape the pursuing stick with sudden curving of thin long body. So then you can imagine that somebody is poking the stick towards the snake and it is curving its slender body. So in this way, this is the which poetic device is used here. It is used here, imagery. Imagery is the poetic device used here. Used in this poem. Then, children, imagery is there in the second paragraph or second stanza also. He glides through the water away from the stroke. That is, no particular rhyming scheme. The poem is in free verse. Okay, so children, there is no particular poetic devices are here. And now we will be discussing the textual question answer. We will be discussing the textual question and answer of this lesson. Now children, within one or two lines I would like to tell you the message given by the writer. The writer is telling that the snake trying is the poet, where we have to see that we all the animals are the creator of God. We should love them, we should respect them. Even if it is the here you can see the snake which is not harming anyone, even he is being chased. If he would have harmful to anyone, if he was a venomous snake, he could have killed. But he was simply a water snake, green color snake, it not at all venomous. And children, he was being chased by the stick. Anyhow, he has disappeared into the ripples of the water and saved himself by hiding in the reed. So in this way, children, the snake has saved himself. And I would like to discuss some of the question and answer. What is the snake trying to escape from? So the tree is the snake is trying to escape from somehow from the children from the attack of the stick. Is it a harmful snake? The poet, what is its color? No, it's not a harmful snake. It conveys that the snake was having a green color and it was not a harmful snake. The poet find the snake beautiful, find the words he used to convey its beauty. So children, according to the poet, he tells that the snake is beautiful. So the poet expresses his beauty in the line words, thin long body, beautiful and graceful, small and green. What does the poet wish for the snake? The poet wished that the snake manages to escape from the water and secure itself amid the water reeds. without getting hurt. Where was the snake before anyone saw it and chased it away? Where does the snake disappear? The snake was lying along the sand before it was unnoticed by the human being, who began chasing it away with a stick. To escape the attack and save itself, the snake glides into the water and disappears among the reed. So children, this is the few question answers which we have completed it. Okay. Now then MCQ question answer is there, extract based question answer is there, and then long question answer is also there. So now we will discuss the two long question answer, and I will tell you summary of the question of this lesson can come. Then children, message and the theme and the message of this question of this chapter can come, and one two more question answer which I am going to discuss it now, and it is long question answer. So first is, how important is to conserve nature and the creator that lives on the earth? How important is to conserve nature and the creatures that live on the earth? Conservation of nature is one of the burning issue of the present day. We notice several species of animals and birds vanishes from the surface of the earth. The children who inherit the world from us will not have the opportunity of seeing these creation, as many of them are becoming extinct, like the sparrows. Now from the next paragraph, every creature on the earth has been sent with a purpose, a duty to perform, and each of these creatures have a role to play in maintaining the ecological balance of the earth. Indiscriminate destruction of flora and fauna is dangerous for the stability of nature. Therefore, it is important for the human being who have taken up the role of destroyer to ponder upon the issue. For the future seems to be grim, as the water, air, and all natural resources are being steadily malignant by the rational creature, that is man. So children, you have written here in 2 to 3 paragraph. I have discussed this also. Now one more question is there. Write a paragraph on your encounter with the snake. In this is a full summary of the poem, in fact. So the sun had risen after the first monsoon shower. It is believed that a snake come out of this homes underground to bask in the warmth of the sun. I was getting out of my house in a little which is in Cork to go to school. It was 8:30 in the morning. As soon as I opened the door and stretched my foot out, I saw a huge rat snake stretched out on the front yard. I screamed. Okay, so children, in this paragraph writing, I mean to say, children, you can write a lot of things. This is a paragraph of writing. You have to write it individually. So, or you, if you have had any experience with the snake, you can share here. Okay, so here you have to write that how you have had a encounter with snake. So children, one question can be like this also. Justified, write a short paragraph in justify the title of the poem. So you have to write a short paragraph to justify the title of the poem. That means, is the poem suitable? Yes, I feel it is quite suitable. Okay, the people are running after to kill a snake, but children, a proverb is there that if you doesn't want to be, if you the if the it is our life is in the hands of God. Okay, it is not if it if God wanted that we should die, we will surely die. Nobody can stop that day. But if no, then nobody can, whatever anybody can do, it will not affect on the creatures. Like in the snake, in here in this poem, children, a human being is there and he is chasing with a stick to the snake, and the snake snakes away and hit himself in the reed. So in this manner he was saved. Okay. So this is the explanation of the poem. We have done the theme, explanation, okay, and the long question answer and the textual question answer of the poem. So with this, I complete my poem here and I conclude my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.